Hi there, Tony Fraser here. I thought I'd just give you a bit of a rundown on the importance of ironstone in prospecting for gold and what it actually is. So I hear a lot of stories, or I have over the years, of prospectors telling me how ironstone represents rocks that have been cooked and baked by volcanoes or extreme heat, you know, because they are black and dark looking rocks and brown rocks, like they've been burnt. So it's kind of understandable, but that's all completely wrong. Now, in fact, what ironstone is basically rusted, nature's rust. That's what it is. It's rusted iron sulfides like this. This is pyrite. And pyrite, once exposed to oxygen above the water table over millions of years, will actually decompose and form iron oxide, aka ironstone, or mineralogically known as limonite. So I've got some examples here just to show you what that looks like, with some nice little crystals of pyrite. So there, your iron sulfide pyrite crystals, and then there's your oxidized versions of what they call limonite after pyrite pseudomorphs, or devil's dice as they're called. So they still maintain the same crystal shape, but one is an iron sulfide and the other one is an iron oxide. So in the gold deposits almost all around the world, you'll always get accessory minerals with the gold's deposition, pyrite being a very common one, especially here in central Victoria. You'll also get galena, which is a lead sulfide, and sphalerite, which is a zinc sulfide, plus various carbonates, siderite, anchorite, dolomite, all sorts of other minerals that are associated with the gold as well. And once they are exposed above the water table, they all decompose and oxidize, forming these iron-based and manganese-based minerals. So there's a specimen there of gold in quartz showing a nice oxidization of limonite around it. Very common in the gold fields and a very good indicator that you are in gold country. Happy hunting.